Everything's a bit brighter. Everything's a bit clearer. Everything is easier to deal with when I'm with you. I don't need pills or plastic. It's all fantastic when you turn on the light in my mind. When you turn on the light, turn on the light.
When you turn on the light.
Hello, my name is George Kappas, and I'm the director of the Hypnosis Motivation Institute, or HMI, in Tarzana, California, America's first nationally accredited college of hypnotherapy. Founded as a nonprofit organization in 1968 by my father and uncle, Drs. John and Alex Kappas, HMI has been our family's mission and purpose for more than 45 years. I did my first hypnosis demonstration here when I was only 9 years old. Students from all over the world come to HMI to receive professional training and clinical internship. If you tuned in today hoping to see people cluck like chickens, then you've got the wrong show. But stay tuned, and we'll show you how real people are using hypnosis and the power of the subconscious mind to accomplish their goals and achieve their dreams. This is Hypnotized.
So as a senior level manager for an organization, it was really problematic that I had this anxiety at these meetings. My anxiety was getting, you know, worse and worse at work. I really was trying to figure out something that I might do about it. I have to be in these meetings, and I cannot continue to feel this way and do my job effectively.
In this episode of Hypnotized, we're going to take a look at one of America's biggest fears, public speaking, or its technical term, glossophobia. In fact, surveys have shown that most people fear public speaking more than they fear death itself. It's been estimated that 75% of all people experience some degree of anxiety about public speaking. But what if hypnosis and the power of our subconscious mind could provide a quick, natural, and drug-free solution to relieving this anxiety? For tonight's episode, we will feature hypnotherapist Michelle Guzzi. She is an HMI graduate and senior staff instructor with over 20 years' experience. With an extensive background as a professional speaker herself, I think she's the perfect fit for this clinical presentation to the students. This is Hypnotized. All right, so we got a clinical case presentation tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And we have an intern who's gonna do the follow-up sessions.
My name is Ina Lee. I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist, and I'm here in my internship at HMI. And tonight I'm gonna go in and talk to George and Michelle and talk about a client that I will be taking over and following you with this case.
Hi,
hi,
come on in. Ina, you know Michelle.
Good to see you.
Ina, you're gonna be our intern that does the follow-up sessions.
Great.
So we're gonna do the first session in class and then six sessions once a week with you afterwards. And Rose has got us a great client, and it's gonna be perfect for Michelle, and I think for you too as well. Rose?
Her name is Barb. She's 54 years old, and as George said, she's has a fear, anxiety of speaking in meetings. She's a chief operating officer of a nonprofit organization.
Okay.
And this is throwing her that she's having trouble speaking in meetings now, because that's what she does as for her profession. So she feels like her heart races, her face flushes, and she stammers when she's in the meetings. And she wants some help with that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
This is the place for her.
Yeah.
We specialize in helping people with, you know, that anxiety, a little stress, and dealing with situations. So I think hypnosis would be perfect for her to just be, you know, she has the confidence and that focus, but how do you get up and do the talk and be real clear with your communication and easy sailing with it, so.
Rose, is this something that started recently, or she always had this?
Yeah, it sounds like it was just something that has just come on her recently.
Oh.
And she's really, it's really throwing her, and she wants to be able to to speak sitting in that meeting.
So I think that's going to be a big question mark. Mm-hmm. Is when did is it started recently and what happened, and if there's something we have to look at, is something bad that happened, some kind of trauma that we need to address first?
Is there a trigger, something going on at work, an employee, a situation?
Onset.
Okay.
And I thought that Ina would be the perfect intern because she looks like a CFO herself.
Yes, she does.
Yes, very corporate. I thought she would relate to you well, and you have a great professional aura about you.
I have to admit, I was a little starstruck to be in the room with George and Michelle. They're both kind of idols to me in the hypnotherapy profession.
So, onset, and let's see where this takes us.
Perfect, sounds
right.
Good.
Good, let's do it.
I personally have three friends that are struggling with the same issue right now.
All right, class, well, thank you so much for being here. My name is Michelle Guzzi, and I want to welcome you to the Hypnosis Motivation Institute, and it's our clinical case presentation. Tonight, we have a very interesting subject coming in. Her name is Barb, and she wants to be able to deal with some of her anxiety of speaking in her board meetings, in her conference meetings. She works with a nonprofit, and she wants to be able to have a little bit more confidence with that. So as a professional speaker and hypnotherapist, I think this is going to be a really exciting case. Let's see what we can do and give her some techniques that she can walk out of here with tonight. Is that okay with you guys? You ready to have some fun? All right, let's bring in Barb.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, are you Barb?
I'm Barb. Hi.
Barb, come
nice on
to meet in.
You.
Nice to meet you. I'm going to actually have you come right over here for me.
When I first came here, and I walked in the room, I was really nervous because my fear is having to speak in front of people. But sitting up at the front and speaking with Michelle, pretty quickly, it really felt like it was just the two of us.
Barb, take it away. Tell me about yourself and what we can best do for you here tonight.
So I'm part of senior management for a nonprofit organization, and I've been there for 13 years. And somehow, I mean, I never could get up, like stand in front of a group. Sitting, I used to be okay. But in the last 2 years, I've started having tremendous anxiety, just in staff meetings, whether I need to present or I want to, even if I want to contribute, and that's sitting. My heart races. I'm sure the person sitting, you know, across the room can hear it. Mm-hmm. It's pounding. My face gets hot, it gets red. Mm-hmm. And then if I actually do somehow find a way to speak, I am sure that my voice is shaking, you know, much like it is right now. And it's really difficult for me to participate.
Okay.
So, and it's a problem because we have these meetings every 2 weeks and I'm the chief operating officer and I need to participate, and we have board meetings 3 times a year, and I often have to, speak about something at the meeting.
Okay.
It seems like it's getting worse.
Now, is it the same people that are at the meetings?
For the staff meetings, yeah.
Same people. And how long have you been working with them?
I've hired most of them. I've been there for 13 years.
Okay.
So, and there's only one other person above me in the organization.
When Barb told me that she was having trouble speaking in front of just a few people that she herself had hired, I was a bit surprised. I guess I expected a situation a little bit more intimidating. But then again, fears don't have to make sense to be powerful. But you're
telling me it's been getting progressively worse.
Yeah.
Have you had a time to where you were able to do a meeting or do a talk, and whether sitting or standing, and it was okay for
sitting,
you?
Sitting, it was okay for a long time.
Okay, so sitting was fine.
Standing, I avoid as much as I can. And I've been able to avoid it for, about 11 years. So I'm doing a good job avoiding
it. Well, you know, at the meetings, do you need to stand at the meetings if you're addressing the board?
Not usually, but we have board meetings 3 times a year, and there will come a time when there will be a topic that I need to present and lead in front of the board.
Okay.
It will happen.
Okay. How long do you normally speak at those special meetings?
I play more of a facilitating role. Okay. So I'm just sort of adding things, but mostly it's the board speaking with themselves.
Good.
Okay. So it's just somebody may ask a question that I might have to answer, mm-hmm. but I do not have to, I'm not presenting information. Mm-hmm. I'm just sort of there as a resource if they need more information about something that they're looking at.
Okay. And you, of course, probably have the information that they need. You've been doing this for a while. So when they ask about some resources, does that information come to you pretty easy?
It does. Mm-hmm. It's just then getting it out.
It's in the mind. Yeah. It's got to be able to come out.
So what I really liked about Michelle was she almost instantly created connection. And for me, feeling connected to someone helps to calm my anxiety pretty quickly.
Once Barb explained the situation she was dealing with, I knew right away that we were going to be able to help her and that I could send her home with some immediate relief to accomplish her goals very quickly.
She seemed to really understand the issue that I was dealing with, and the questions that she asked me were very thought-provoking and had me think about it in a totally different way.
Well, some people think that public speaking is a minor issue. The reality is that public speaking can affect some people's careers, it can affect their education, and it can be crippling.
So at this point in the session, I recognized that Barbara had already entered a highly suggestible state, so I took the opportunity to start presenting a series of suggestive ideas. I'm basically laying the foundation for the suggestions I will give her in hypnosis.
In the last 2 years, I've started having tremendous anxiety, just in staff meetings. And it's really difficult for me to participate.
So we know that when we get a little bit nervous, and even as a professional speaker, and I've done many, many, many seminars, you still get nervous in the beginning. That's normal, okay? How about, instead of being nervous, what do we want to change it to instead? Because we can incorporate all of this and use this. That nervous energy can kind of move us forward to do what?
I would like to be relaxed and confident.
I like it. Okay, how else do you want to be? Relaxed, confident?
Comfortable.
Comfortable.
And like my mm-hmm. I can't get my breath past here right now. Mm-hmm. I'd really like to be able to mm-hmm. be, you know, kind of grounded in my body and breathe.
I like it. Okay, so we are gonna do some breathing exercises with hypnosis today. And would it be okay with you if I do a grounding exercise with you as
sure.
well? Okay?
Yeah.
Because I do that a lot with clients. By giving Barb a grounding exercise, it allows her to be very present, mind, body, and emotions. This allows her to stay very anchored and very centered no matter what's happening. And I'm going to tell you right now, Barb, nobody at the board meeting, nobody with a nonprofit needs to know what you're doing. Okay? So this Secret Service stuff here. So it's not as if we're going to stand up and say, hold on, I need to anchor right now. I'm doing my hypnosis technique.
Right.
But it's all going to be internal. And it's going to be so simple that we're going to use a key word or two.
Okay.
We're going to incorporate our deep breath because we breathe 24/7, so we might as well use it.
Right.
And then let's also anchor, which is an anchor. How about this? Let me explain it to you. I grew up in Alaska, and I grew up fishing with my family. And if we went out into the ocean with the boat and we wanted to stop the boat, we'd throw what into the ocean?
The anchor.
The anchor. And the anchor kind of stabilizes it. Now, we may move a little bit. The boat mm-hmm. may still move, but that anchor keeps us safe and stable.
Right.
So when I say anchor, that's a physical, mental, and emotional state that if any stress, tension, or anxiety tries to come up, when we fire our anchors or throw that anchor into the water or into what we call our subconscious mind, instantly reverses that negative state, and you can have that relaxation, that calmness, and that comfortability. Even though Barb is already in a highly suggestible state, it's time to formally induce hypnosis and really take her suggestibility and receptiveness to the next level. Now you're going to take your left arm and hand and put it up on the desk for me. And keep your elbow right here. Okay, there you go. And I want you to look directly at me because I'm just going to ask you a couple questions here.
Okay.
Now, there's not going to be any more talking because I'm just going to observe body language. And if the answer is yes, you nod. If it's no, you shake your head no. If you're not sure, you stare directly at me because I'll find the answers in your eyes. They do funny little things. Okay, you ready? All right, has anybody ever told you that you've ever walked or talked in your sleep in your adult life? Mm-hmm. When you were young, could you express your feelings to people around, like family and friends? Very good. Are you able to do that now? Okay. Have you ever had a situation where you woke up in the middle of the night, maybe from a dream, and you felt like you could not move your body or talk? Okay. Are you able to imagine a lemon? Can you think about a lemon right now? If you were to imagine biting into a very sour, bitter lemon, would your mouth begin to water? If you were to just think about it. You're going to look at your arm from your elbow all the way down to your fingertips and get a really, really good picture of the arm and hand for me right now. Good. And then just close your eyes for me. So we're going in. Bring your attention down to the elbow, the one that's pressing down on the desk. And as this elbow presses down on the desk, the muscles in your upper arm will begin to tighten and pull. Mm-hmm. And then from your elbow all the way down to the fingertips, Barb, now your lower left arm and hand is going to begin to lift and rise. Elbow will stay on the table and the arm and hand is going to lift and rise and just go up higher and higher. Lighter and lighter, just as light as a feather. In order to put somebody into hypnosis very effectively, we use an arm-raising induction. It allows them to open up the subconscious mind to be very receptive to all the suggestions we're giving them. Tie it in with the breathing now. Nice deep breaths in. And now this left arm and hand is going to begin to twist and turn inward at the wrist, so the palm of the hand and the fingertips start coming up and in towards the face. It's now twisting and turning and lifting and rising. Good. So that arm and hand now is going to come in.
As an intern scheduled to do the follow-up sessions with Barb, I was really happy to see that she's responding so strongly to hypnosis.
Nice and easy. And when that hand comes all the way up and touches the face, you will reach what we call a peak of suggestibility, and you will go into the hypnotic state. This will be extremely effective. Very easy for you. It might even trigger a little bit of a smile because it's a nice feeling, isn't it? Just to relax and breathe and connect with you. Ready? And deep sleep. Hold it there now. At this stage in the session, it's time for us to take the ideas we've been talking about with Barb intellectually and start turning them into strong feelings at a subconscious level. Ultimately, it will be Barb's feelings that change her behavior and not her intellect. 5, 4. Nice deep breath. 3. Just allow an emotional calmness to spread going down. 2 is going to represent you mentally. Get focused now. 1. And 0 is deep sleep. Now that's going to be your connection. Your connection. Excellent. Now bring your attention all the way down to the feet. This is your grounding process. I want you to imagine the soles of your feet just opening up in your energy. You have wonderful, beautiful energy. I want your energy to just go down to the floor, all the way down to the center of the earth. Because you are helping people on the planet, aren't you? You are helping the earth. And because of this nonprofit and this good intention that you have, and you're so capable of doing that, that whenever you want to get really connected with your cause and really connected with being able to speak and present, all you have to do is imagine that you're just drawing on that beautiful energy. So from the soles of your feet now, bring it all the way up. All the way up into the legs, all the way up into the knees and the thighs and the hips. And your body now just releasing, relaxing, and letting go of any stress and tension of the day. And it becomes a whole mind-body connection, doesn't it? All the way into the facial muscles. Now, relax the jaw for just a second. Yeah. When we speak and we're really comfortable with what we're saying, the jaw's relaxed, yeah. And whenever you're getting ready to present, whether it's in your staff meetings or your board meetings, just stop and breathe and relax the jaw. That relaxation goes into the face, goes all the way up into the top of the head, And that energy goes up to the center of the universe. And I want you going into these meetings and these presentations with that big heart and positive energy. Let's go a little bit deeper again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And deep sleep.
By giving Barb the physical anchor of connecting her hands, we are giving her a powerful tool that allows her to recreate these positive feelings anywhere and anytime in the future that she may need them.
Show me the position with your hands that's going to establish everything we're talking about today. How do we go into the relaxation? And so that's when you get connected, isn't it? And funny, because that's the left and the right hand that's connected. So that's the left and the right brain that's getting connected. And that is the logic and the emotions that are working together. And that's what makes a really good speaker and presenter, that you come from both sides of the mind. Can I give you a little bit of a speaking secret? Silence is golden. Silence is confidence. Silence draws everybody into your energy and they get really grounded with you. And I bet you if you just stopped and you did that and you took a couple deep breaths in, the entire room would start to breathe with you and just relax. And when those hands come together and you make that decision that it's your turn to talk, you'll speak easily, you'll speak effortlessly, and the confidence in your information will come out.
One of the things that Michelle gave me at my first meeting with her was an anchor. It's probably been one of the best tools that I've been given since I came here. I can use it before I'm in a meeting, and I can do it while I'm in the meeting. And because it's physical, it actually helps to ground me. And no one knows that I'm doing it. And it calms me, it allows me, it helps me to do my job.
I really liked what Michelle did with Barbara and hypnosis. I took a lot of notes because I think many of these suggestions could be used for other issues as well.
My heart races. I'm sure the person sitting, you know, across the room can hear it. Mm-hmm. It's pounding. My face gets hot. It gets red.
Mm-hmm. Just speak, my dear, when you're in the meetings. Just let it come from the heart and allow the information to flow. You got this. So when I count from 0 to 5, each count will be more aware and very much alert and awake. And anytime you feel you're going into any stress, tension, or overload, or that anxiety, you stop and you count yourself out, which will block that anxiety, block any of that fear. Do you understand? Let me do it first for you. So 0, ready? Shut that door to the subconscious mind. All those negatives now are in the past. Any of that anxiety, it's in the past. It will no longer control and affect you in a negative way. You are now grounded, calm, and relaxed. All meetings, all situations, you can handle anything and everything.
The suggestions Michelle is giving Barb in hypnosis provides me a blueprint to follow for the remaining sessions.
Coming up, 1, 2, back to the room. 3 now, more aware and alert, which means the eyes are going to slowly start opening now. 3, 4, and 5 is going to be eyes open. And wide awake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. Eyes open. Wide awake.
As I bring Barb out of the hypnotic state, she is going to remain highly suggestible for the next few minutes. Often, subjects become even more suggestible as their defenses drop down just a little bit. I'm going to take this opportunity to demonstrate to the students how what we say to the subject immediately after hypnosis is sometimes just as important and effective as what we say in hypnosis.
I want you to be in charge of this whole speaking presentation. Be in charge. If that anxiety comes up, you make a fist with this right hand, you grab it,
because this is going to tell the left brain that no, this is not okay with me.
Okay.
And just count yourself out, say, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, wide awake, blocking all of fear and anxiety. Do it as many times as you need to, and then release it, relax it. You get grounded. You put your hands together. You get very associated. And boom, you go into that experience, you go into that meeting. Got it?
Got it.
Excellent. Yay! How you feeling?
Great.
You did amazing.
Thank you.
You did amazing.
That's
all right.
Awesome.
Yeah, sit up for me for a second. How'd she do, class? Really good. I think the class went into hypnosis. Let's count them out. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Eyes open, wide awake, wide awake. So you have some techniques that you can do, and you have been doing this for such a long time. But go in there and just speak.
Okay.
Yeah, you do know the information. Get grounded, get centered. Take a moment. Control the environment, okay? Get CEO and you got you. You're the top two people. Be in charge. Make it happen.
Thank you so much.
So nice to see you. All right,
thank
I'll see you.
You
soon. Yay! Your therapist is going to be Ms. Lee here, Ina Lee, and she's going to be assisting you with some of the sessions and do a few more things. If you need anything, you let us know.
Sure.
Okay, and we're looking forward to hearing your progress and, you know, all that success. All right, so say thanks to Barb for coming on in. And Ina's going to go and get you set up for group sessions, okay? Mm-hmm.
All right, 6 weeks. So let's talk about Barbara. You started her out with the first session. I watched that. That was good.
Good.
What did you think?
I thought she did really good. I mean, I thought she picked up the associations and the suggestions really well. I know we did some anchoring techniques for her so she could start to implement them immediately with the techniques. And I think she went into hypnosis pretty good. And
I think she had
a great response to the whole thing. So.
Yeah, seemed like she went really deep. Mm-hmm. And she seemed really relieved when she came out. Okay, and you made a good start with her, and I think she reported some results right away. Mm-hmm. With it, and then we turned her over to you for the next 5 weeks.
Yeah.
How did it go?
It went well. I still continue to see her, but she's responsible to hypnosis, and her anxiety has been reduced significantly. And she doesn't have her fear for public speaking right now.
Yeah, since she's done a presentation or two. And
she's done multiple presentations, so she doesn't have any anxiety at all she stands up and speaks in front of the people.
That's great.
Perfect.
Now, so what did you learn?
I've learned that people respond well in hypnosis and they can change their beliefs about themselves, and their subconscious mind also is very powerful.
So what beliefs do you think Barb had to change?
Beliefs about herself.
What about it?
That she is powerful and basically she can do anything that she would like to do for herself.
Mm-hmm.
And it could be from public speaking, from to anything else.
Just empowerment. That's what we gave her, just some levels of empowerment and change. Hypnotherapy is a very powerful tool. It allows us to work with the subconscious mind to give effective suggestions. It helps people create change in their life to allow success, happiness, and prosperity.
After my first session at HMI, within a week I had a meeting, and I was really surprised at how much more relaxed I was and how I was able to communicate more clearly and be more effective. And that's the way that I need to be at my job. It's also really changed my outlook, and I feel calmer, more positive. Some of the mindfulness techniques that I did with Ina have really had me stop and slow down and have greater appreciation for what's around me. And I'm having a better time. I'm enjoying my life more.
Well, this is what I call a win-win situation. Our client Barb overcame her fear of public speaking. HMI students got a great real-life example. And now you have a greater understanding of how hypnotherapy can be a powerful resource to improve our lives. But it does beg the question, If hypnosis and the power of the subconscious mind can naturally and easily help Barb overcome a fear that has been plaguing her for years, what else can it do? We hope to answer that question and more in the next episode of Hypnotized.
Take the time to let it air in. In a moment you will feel the land. Just let it in. Just let it in. Just let it in.